We proved just now additive properties. Now we will see that multiplication property, right? In complex numbers, multiplication property satisfies associative. Consider three complex numbers, alpha, beta, gamma. Three complex numbers. We have to show that multiplication is associative property. That is alpha beta into gamma equal to alpha into beta gamma. We have to prove this one. Right. First we will simplify this and simplify this one. If both are same, then we can show this, say that multiplication is associative. Right. Let alpha equal to e comma d and beta c comma d gamma e comma f. So for finding that alpha beta into gamma, first we will find out what is the value of alpha beta. Alpha beta a b c d, and we know that in multiplicative a comma d, a comma b, c comma d, the multiplication of these two is what? AC minus BD comma AD plus BC. We know this one, right? AC minus BD comma AD plus BC. This is alpha beta. Now we'll find out alpha beta into gamma. That is, what is the value of alpha beta? We have AC minus BD comma AD plus BC into gamma value. What is the gamma value? E comma F, right? Apply this property, AC minus BD comma AD plus BC. AC minus BD into E value minus AD plus BC into F comma. Next, AD. AC minus BD into F plus. Right? Just consider, observe, this is as A and this one as B and it has C and it has D. But this one AC minus BD, AC minus BD, comma. Next one is what? AD, AD plus BC, BC, right? So here we can do multiplication, general multiplication. ACE minus BDE minus ADF minus BCF. Next, ACF minus BDF plus ADE plus BCE. Is there any cancellation in this one? ACE, BDE, ADF, BDF, nothing, there is no cancellation, right? This is the value of LHS one, alpha beta into gamma. Find out the value of alpha into beta gamma. Alpha into beta gamma. First, we will find out beta gamma, then multiply with alpha. Beta gamma. What is the value of beta here? Beta c comma d into what is that gamma? E comma f. Right? Same as like this. Alpha beta ac minus bd comma ad plus bc. If you have any confusion, just identify as A, B, C, D. So what is the value? AC minus BD comma AD plus BC, right? Without confusion, just write down this one. So AC. So what is the value of A here? C. C into, C value is A minus BD. B value is D into D value is F. Come. Next, AD plus BC. A, D plus B, C. Right? So this is the value of beta gamma. Now, we will find out alpha into beta gamma. Right? So alpha value is what here? What is that value of alpha? A comma B. A comma B into beta gamma value. CE minus DF comma. CF plus D. Again, it is in the form of ABCD. Apply this property. AC. AC minus BD value. Right? Next, AD plus BC. AD plus BC. B into C value. So now here we have the multiplication, multiply ACE minus ADF minus BCF minus BDE. Next, this one, ACF plus ADE plus BCE minus BDE, right? This is the RHS answer. Now, observe the LHS answer and RHS answer. Both are same or not, just verify. ACE minus BDE, next, minus ADF minus BCF. Similarly, these are also same, right? So, we can say that alpha beta into gamma equal to alpha into beta gamma. It shows that multiplication satisfies associative property. Right? Now, we have to prove that multiplicative identity exists and unique. Multiplicative identity exists and unique. Right? Let alpha equal to a comma b belongs to complex number and one number n equal to 1 comma 0 is belongs to complex number. We have to show that alpha into n equal to n into alpha equal to alpha. Then we can say that n is multiplicative identity, right? So we will find out alpha into n value. What is that alpha here? A comma b. And what is the value of n? 1 comma 0. It is in the form of a comma b c comma d. Applying this formula, AC minus BD comma AD plus BC, AC minus BD comma, next one is what? AD plus BC, AD plus BC, that is A comma B, which is nothing but alpha only. So, see, we got it, alpha into N equal to alpha. Similarly, if you simplify, N into alpha will get it alpha. From these two, we can say that alpha N equal to N into alpha equal to alpha, which is nothing but N is called multiplicative identity of alpha. And same as in addition property, we can show that this multiplicative identity is uniqueness.